A very good morning to all of you. Today I am going to start a new unit, that is trigonometry. For examination point of view, this is very important unit. So I would request you please pay attention. In the beginning, let me introduce the topic. Trigonometry means the science which deals with the measurement of triangles. The word trigonometry is derived from the Greek word trigon and metron. It means measuring the sides and the angles of a triangle. So now all of us know what is an angle. An angle is a measure of rotation of a given ray about its initial point. The original ray is called the initial side, and the final position of the ray after rotation is called terminal side of the angle. The point of rotation is called the vertex. If the direction of rotation is anti-clockwise, the angle is said to be positive, and if the direction of rotation is clockwise, then the angle is negative, as it is shown here in the figure. Now, moving ahead, let me discuss the different system for the measurement of angles. And I am going to discuss three different systems. And the very first one is British system. This is also known as sexagesimal system. In this system, 1/360th of a complete circular turn is called a degree. Also, 1/60 of a degree is called a minute, and 1/60th of the minute is called second. That is, one right angle is equal to 90 degree, 1 degree is equal to 60 minute, 1 minute is equal to 60 second. Next system for measurement of angle is the French system. It is also known as centesimal system. In this system, 1/400 part of a complete circular turn is called a grade. Also, 1/100th of a grade is called a minute, and 1/100th of a minute is called a second. That is, one right angle is equal to 100 grade, one grade is equal to 100 minute, and 1 minute is equal to 100 second. But it is very important at this point of time to note the minutes and the second in sexagesimal system, that is British system, are different with the minutes and second respectively in centesimal system, that is French system. Symbol in both the system are also different. Now the third system for measurement of angle is the radian measurement, which is commonly used by all of us. The angle subtended by an arc of a circle whose length is equal to the radius of the circle at the center of the circle is called a radian. In this system, the unit of measurement is radian, as the circumference of a circle of radius 1 unit is 2 pi. Therefore, one complete revolution of the initial side subtends an angle of 2 pi radian at the center. More generally, in a circle of radius r, an arc of length r will subtend an angle of 1 radian. It is well known that equal arcs of a circle subtends equal angle at the center. This we have already studied in class 9. Since in a circle of radius r, an arc of length r subtends an angle whose measure is 1 radian, an arc of length L, so I am assuming here the length of arc as L, will subtend an angle whose measure is L by R, that is length of arc divided by the radius of the circle, L by R radian. Thus, if in a circle of radius R, the length of arc L subtends an angle theta radian at the center, then we can formulate it as it is formulated for you here, theta is equal to L by R, or length of arc L is equal to R into theta. Theta is the angle made at the center by the length of arc L. It is important to note, if no symbol is mentioned while showing measurement of the angle, then it is considered to be measured in radian. That is, if anywhere it is given theta is equal to 15, this implies it is 15 radian. Using this concept, we can find the area of the sector. So area of sector we can write here as 1 by 2 r square into theta. And since theta is equal to L by R, so also we can write 1 by 2 R into L, where L is length of arc. Now, what is the relation between these three systems for measurement of angles? Pi by 2 radian, it is equal to 90 degree, and this is equal to 100 grades. So using this concept, we will solve some questions so that the concept is clear. Thank you for today.